this first game of a match, I was white and I played Nimtze Ingen. We call this Romanian variations. I had some ideas in this variation and played it relatively successful. What? Yes. Yeah, but it was not so favorable for white line. Yeah. Yasser is not a big fan of long theoretical lines. He prefers to play something solid and not force. So I didn't prepare sharper lines. By the way, this variation was used with Garry Kasparov too in the second match with Karpov, and he became world champion, big part because successful play in this line. Now, I believe it's already not so popular because long theoretical lines give black safe positions in some lines. Yasser castle and play d6. So he wants to play e5. Well, generally, it's logical if black exchange his before bishop. He wants to have pawns on black squares, bishop on white square. It is simple theory goes from Wilhelm Steinitz. Now he exchanged bishop and played knight d7 with idea e5. Our way is knight c6. And after this e5, it is more active because if black play knight c6, one of ideas to play knight a5, b6, bishop a6. It was in very interesting, my interesting game with Andrei Sokolov in that year's one of brightest new stars. He played very successful, and strangely enough, his results went down when he lost equal match to Artur Yusuf, a semi-final match of candidates. Winner played with Karpov, and win of that match, it was Karpov, he played his first match with Kasparov. Okay, so d6, knight d7, so it is not so active setup. Knight on a5 and bishop on a6 would be more active. Yes. So Yasser played knight d7. So nevertheless, he can attack my c-pawn. So white's setup is to protect the pawn, to open squares to my pieces. So I played queen d3. I plan to play knight d2. Now bishop will be open. Knight will have good routes to b3 or on e4. e5, knight d2. I have to play it before castle because black already has threat e4. If I would castle first, I could not have this setup with queen d3, knight d4. I would lose my knight. Knight d4, rook e8. Now already I might castle. Queen e7. In such position, if he will play, I would give him to play e4. He will close my bishop and he will receive good game. So I have to play e4. Now, when my bishop is closed, he play b6. It looks like his idea to bring bishop on a6 and attack my c-pawn. I play rook e1. Now it's extra protection to EvoPawn. Now I can move my knight in any direction. Pawn is underprotected. For example, if he play here a5, repairing bishop a6, not blockading his pawns, I have time to play knight f1, bishop a6, knight e3. Now my c4 pawn protected, and my knight can jump on d5 or on f5, a very promising position. So because of this, black played bishop e6 immediately, but it has serious drawbacks, positional drawbacks. Bishop is blockade his a7 pawn. Now white has two plans. One is more active but more sharp, and our is to play a4 a5 using the position of a6 as a trigger to my advantages through a pawn. I made it, but it was also possible to play knight e1. If now I black because knight e3 with this idea is knight d5, knight e5 very unpleasant, black has to play aggressive approach. He has to take. Now d5 very attractive, but not so good. Strangely enough, all my pawns are pinned, yeah? But nevertheless, I can move e5. D takes c4 is better. I move my queen, and knight doesn't have good moves. And if he takes knight c4, I play queen c2. His knight doesn't have good moves because knight pawn d5 is hanging. And if he plays knight e4, I play f3. Take f4, white has big position advantage. I can take on d5 or on f7, and my pawns are very good. Yeah? But black has better way. I think he will choose this better way. It is after exchange of d4 to play c5. I cannot play d5 because knight e5 and he wins my c4 pawn. And after knight e3, he takes on d4. Play probably queen e5. So his knights have excellent squares. Second knight can come to c5. Bishop can return b7, attacking pawn e4. For example, if he play here rook d1, he play knight c5. And after he take on d6, he takes on e4. Positions is approximately equal. So I played more challenging approach. I play until my center is protected. I play a4. Now, after inevitable a5, black would have problem through a file. Now, if black takes on g4, and take c5, I already can move d5. Now, pawn c4 is protected. Knight f, no, I think knight f5 is more challenging. Just a moment. Yes, widely. Queen C2 or Queen C3, and white position is very comfortable. I played bishop before and can play after this at 4 e5. So black played again more logical move in position. Yeah, he plays C5 here. Now again, he can take several times on G4, and his knights will have a good square, so I have to play D5. Now to move bishop from A6 doesn't make sense. I play A5. He played knight F8. So what white has to do? First idea to play A5. Probably he will play queen d7 with idea b6 b5. And to have good position, you have to have good pieces. If your pieces probably Steyn said if one piece is placed badly, or Taras probably, all game is bad. So a4 a5 is my plan, but can do it later. First of all, I have to read off my bad pieces. What I have to play here, I played. Knight f8, yes. Yeah, I played knight. Yes, if I play here a5, my old analysis showed that rook ab8 best move, and black plays b5 in position become equal. So immediately a5 is not so good. I improve my knight. Knight goes to f1. Generally, he has to stay on c3, breaking a5 square and going to f5. He played knight g6. And now to play with pawns, I have too many bad pieces, which is not useful. For example, f4 immediately he takes and play knight h5, attacking f4 pawn. If f5, knight e5, and I'm worse, and if I play queen e3, queen h4, he's attacking my rook and attacking my pawn. So I cannot play with pawns until my pieces on the bed, because I have not useful pieces. If I play knight e3, he has moved bishop c8, and knight e5 would be very good, but here he takes, play e4, and knight e5. Pawn attacks my c4 pawn, and I'm again worse. So if to think what problem in my position, again, if your one piece is not useful, or position is not useful, yeah. I played bishop h3. Bishop is good. And black played bishop a8. Of course, bishop on e6 was not useful, and at least I read off one of my bishops. If I play here bishop f5, he takes, play e4, knight e5, and again black is better. Knight f3 or knight d3. So I read from one bishop. So I have to play a5, but immediately a5. He would play, for example, h6, and how I will use my c1 bishop for actions through a file or for any actions. Bishop is not useful. So because of this bishop g5, now What has Fred to play queen f3, for example, if he plays a5, stopping my pawn, I attack b6 pawn, rook b8, and play queen e3. And now, generally, black's position is very bad because my knight goes on f5, and in any moment I can take on f6, spoiling his pawns. And with three weak pawns on f6, d6, and b6, he would lose. So he has to play h6 immediately, rid of pin. I exchange my bishop. So now I don't have pieces which I don't need. And I start to play using a file. How white here has clear initiative. Yes, I take open file on queen side. If he play rook, rook a8, I first double rook, rook a3, second rook on a1, and can take on b6. So he has to prepare defense on queen side. But maybe if he would try to avoid this passive defense, I told you many strong players go to any sacrifices not to receive passive position. So maybe he could play, maybe it was more promising. Now I have extra pawn, but I have to rid of rook from b2, and because my extra pawn is double pawns on c file, maybe it was better defense for black. But logic of any chess player, why I have to give my pawn if nothing is threatening. So black played knight f8. He's preparing to defend d6 pawn with knight from d7. And he thinks, yes, his only weakness is protected, and how white can reach advantage. So I told you, problem for black with white position is better permanently. I can to press and press and press, and in spite presses, maybe not so strong, any defensive position can be, any defense can be destroyed. So I take, play rook a7. I analyzed rook a7. It is approximately the same. Now he has to prepare knight d7, maybe rook b8, queen d8, knight d7, and he's still worse. Which move is better, rook a7 or rook a6, I cannot say. Probably they're equally good. So see, it is significantly different with previous game. In previous game, changing any moves of white, generally almost any move until the end of a game, when I had, I'm sure, not only way to win, I would lose any advantage. Here I can play rook a6, rook a7. White position is stably better. So he received the same position. Now I have to bring knight in the game, but knight e3 immediately would be not good because queen f3 and all my advantages disappear. Yes, we have to be careful even in better position. Knight is pinned. Queen has to protect e4 pawn. And he is ready to play knight d7, knight f6 with advantage. So I have to play prophylactic move. In this game, it's not so many prophylactic, but generally all my moves are possible to consider prophylactic. Yeah? King g2. Now I can bring knight in the game, queen e7. Now I have to take care about a file, I play queen b1, queen b7, queen b5. Now he is ready to play rook a7, fighting for a file, but the sixth pawn has to be protected. Knight d7, queen a4. Now he doesn't have rook a8, and I have red rook a7. Knight f6, rook a7, queen c8, f3. Now white has very safe position on king side. It has control to every square. I have a file permanently. And only question, black's position is very stable. He has only one relative weakness on b6. And how can I break through? So he plays g6. It takes control to f5 square. It's very reasonable. Knight e3, h5. Now white has increase his advantage. And very important, when we have chance to increase activity of our pieces, we have to do this. I played queen c6. Now exchange on c6 is bad because my knight will jump on d5. He will have to take it, and it will be protected. As pawn on c6, it will be clearly winning. So he defend his weaknesses. Now so he can have counterplay with h4 and knight h5. So what we have to do, prevent counterplay, h4. Now he doesn't have any chances on king side, and he has to wait what I can to do. Now, I of course, I could take pawn on b6, rook b8, queen, let's see, on the board, on b6, rook c6, queen c7, rook b2. Check. And he cannot make anything useful. Somewhere you have to defend eighth rank against my rook. And generally, this position not attractive at all. So he decided. Wait. White play. Wait. I played knight g2. Now, when I win his b6 pawn, and I will win it somewhere, he will not have b2 square knight guarded. So again, it is prophylactic. Yeah. Generally, in this game, we also find that many things white made is prophylactical. Even exchange of my ball of bishops. Strangely, I have had the same advantage, theoretically, as in previous game, to all bishops. But what was useful is it was easy to read them. So normal prophylactic, I prevent, defend b2 square. Now I can take pawn, rook b8, queen a5, but he will jump to b1. So I don't want to do this, but I have to. I took the pawn. As I wrote in my annotation for New in Chess magazine, that looks like I tried to find best moves, not with head, but with hands. iterate this, iterate that. But when position of your opponent is passive, you can make this. Now I have full control to a file. Now after rook d8, I would play knight f2. Or I think maybe the knight f2. And I have some active plans, for example, to bring knight on g5. But I think at least it was better defense for him. Yasser decided to exchange queens in concrete without queens, without extra double pawn, he would make a draw. But I think endgame is easier for white to play, because now I start to move my king on queen side. And now exchange of rooks would be big relief for black, yes? Because my rook is clearly better than his rook. It's strange in this game, we saw that each piece has a weight, and its weight can be different with nominal value. One rook is better than our. Bishops can be worse than knights when you and you have to read of them. Rook a6. So one of white's idea could be to bring knight on b5. In this case, d6 pawn will be weak. Yeah? King has 7 in c2. So now I eliminate any counterplay of black. So it's prophylactical maneuver. And generally, white king can somewhere to, for example, if knight on b5, I can move my king somewhere on e5. So he played knight e8. If he played knight d7, knight e3, knight b6, g4, I would start to play on king side. He cannot give me to take on h5, because in this case, knight will go to e5, and h5 pawn will be weak. And if he exchange, I will have idea with e5, and if king will move to h pawn, knight e5, and I would win d6 pawn. So I think position which was somewhere in the distance between better for white and winning move on the scale to side winning. So he played knight b6, knight e3. So at least now knight guard my knight. My knight cannot go forward, so he played. No, it is in variation we analyzed. So after rook b6, king c2, he played knight e8. Now his rook can move because d6 extra protected. Knight e3, he goes on this f6 back. Now g4 is not good, he will take, and I cannot take with f pawn because knight e4. Pawn e4 is hanging. So I move my knight. So clearly, idea of white is clear. Knight goes to g2, to b3, to a5, and to c6, or from c6 maybe to a7 and on b5. So it is like from a different game. Knight will make kind of slalom in sky skiing. Knight d7, knight g2, knight b8. It is an interesting idea. If I play natural move nature moves it, is what is rook a8. Yeah, I cut his pieces, but he played knight d7, and I cannot play knight b3 because knight b6, and he is winning my c4 pawn. And if I cannot move knight d3, I have to take somewhere my rook, and it happened that I lost time. So after rook b8, I went not on a8, but back to a1. He played king d8. Now, defend against penetration my pieces from king's, queen's side. Moving knight on a5 is not attractive, but he will simply play rook b6. But when all his pieces moved on queen's side, knight on b8, king on g8, we know from games of Alekhine usually, but it happened in middle game with attack on king side, but nevertheless, white start to play on king side. I waited for this moment for very long, g4. Now, he cannot permit me to exchange on h5, as we discussed, yes, because I would play it after this knight f1, knight g3, and my knight goes or on a5 and on h5, so he exchange. And his king goes to meet my pawn. If I somewhere would play it h5, his king will come and catch my pawn. So again, I white move on queen side, knight b3. Now, if he plays really actually f5, I take and play g5, and this position is bad because my knight move h5, and clearly white passed pawns is much dangerous than blacks. And I still have some prospects on queen side too. So king went to f6. Now h5, king g5 is he defend on king side. So you know it's like now I think association with tennis when player hit ball in one corner of court in other corner. Now when he came to right corner, I go to left corner. Rook a8, knight d7, knight a5. Now it looks like black's position is very bad. I have a lot of ideas now. But after his next move, his defense will be break very fast. I don't think he has anything better. He played rook b8. Now white was force winning at last. Look on position. Here is a lot of geometry. You see, a black king on f6 is a main defender of black. Because it guards my h and g pawn, and he is ready to protect d pawn. And suddenly, after this very sudden check, black's position is collapsing. He cannot go to a7 because knight c6. Knight has this very useful quality to give forks, to make forks. So he has to go here. And now I winning exchanging rooks. It's strange because my rook is so good and he is so bad, but now I exchange and play knight b7 and he cannot defend d6 pawns. With two extra pawns, of course, he will be losing. If you play knight d7, for example, knight d6, and I can go with king to c6, and his last, when we are losing our last instinct to, as a fish who is on the hook, start to try to fight. It is kind of this fish's move, f5. Now I have to play precisely take, take, and not knight d6, king g6, and his king can, he has two passed pawns, and his king can jump on c5, so on h5 somewhere. So h5, last exact move. Now white would have two extra pawns in better position. So f4, king knight d6. If f3, king d3, and I take his pawn, and in our case, king goes to e4, knight goes check on f5, and my pawns go, three passed pawns will run to eighth rank. Yes, I made one more move, knight d7, and after king d3, he resigned because it is a very appropriate moment. Strange, but I make winning moves, losing all my advantages. I exchange my good rook. I played g5, destroying chances for passed pawn. But chess is a concrete game. So what we saw here in these games, in this game, very important moment, we have to guard not to have a bad piece which is unuseful. It is bad not because it's bad itself, but because it's bad in this position. For example, my bishops had excellent diagonals, but I could not use it. I didn't need these bishops on diagonal, so I rid off these bishops. I had advantage with my A file, so I had to keep this advantage, not to be in hurry. You see, I repeated positions, but my advantage was stable. Not in any moment it became less, it only increases in or be stable. White made all necessary prophylactic moves, eliminating any chances black of counterplay. Especially it was important in the opening when I didn't give him options to exchange on d-pawn to play c5. And you see, if your advantage even small, but your opponent doesn't have counterplay, it all experienced players, the masters know this, your situation is desperate because your opponent will press and press and press until position will become really bad. So it's very important to avoid passive position and try to create counterplay.